The remarks by the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, are in response to a decision by Parliament to hold a meeting between the opposition, government and Uganda Human Rights Commission to discuss how the investigations into the alleged 18 missing people will be executed after the commission insisted it had exhausted its investigations.
But I want to give her a second chance to redeem her image, her personal image and her competence levels. Okay? We're not going to condemn somebody without giving them a second chance.
Addressing the press today at Parliament on the fate of the issues of gross human rights violations and enforced disappearances following opposition return to Parliament, Mpuuga vowed not to relent on the matter until all justice is served for the lives lost and missing persons are accounted for.
So I want to inform the country that the matter of the missing 18 are not lost. And therefore, I have received a correspondence from the Speaker inviting me for the meeting on Monday to discuss the nature, scope, and breadth of this inquest on the missing 18, including the issue of the slain Muslim clerics.
Mpuuga also revealed that, unlike in the past, where the Uganda Human Rights Commission conducted investigations behind closed doors, this time around, the investigations must be held in public spaces so as to ensure integrity and transparency of the contents of the report.
We are going to demand for a public inquest of the Human Rights Commission. They must do a public inquiry, not a secretary inquiry, where they make phone calls from the comfort of their cozy offices and then make reports.
He noted that their prayers are not falling on deaf ears, revealing that the Attorney General has already written to Parliament seeking information of the people alleged to be rotting in detention without trial for appropriate action.
Hopefully next week we'll have an idea of how much time they're going to use, because House is over that these persons that are in detention without trial beyond the time prescribed by the Constitution should be either given bail or freed, because the state has failed to prosecute them.
Mpuuga has also tasked the two committees of Parliament, that is, Human Rights Committee and Defence and Internal Affairs, which were tasked to investigate the matter, to do a thorough job that will deliver justice to victims.
Over killings, murders of various nature, defilement, rape, property destruction, theft, and outright robbery by men and women in uniform, or property belonging to people in fishing communities across the country.
In their statement, the government blamed the relatives of the said missing persons for failure to cooperate with security agencies, which has made the search very difficult. This week, Parliament rejected a prayer by the opposition for the establishment of a judicial commission of inquiry to investigate the matter of gross human rights violations that saw the opposition boycotting Parliament for over a month. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.